Hey VC, Rock Chica here, doing a quick video of some recent finds and what I've been listening to and what I've been buying. So in the background right now, you're listening to English Muffins, the Mystic Moods Orchestra. So I've had this in my collection for I don't know how long, picked it up because of the cover, and never really listened to it. So right now I think we're listening to Early in the Morning. Next up will be Ticket to Ride, Color of My Love, Here, There, and Everywhere, Love Grows. So it has Beatle covers and Bee Gees covers. A couple other ones I'm not too familiar with, but there you go. Kind of cheesy. I don't think I'll be keeping this. So that'll be going in the for sale pile. Before that, I was listening to this, Duke Ellington. I've had this in my collection for a while as well, and was inspired by Mazzy. I was listening to Mazzy's video last night about the Verve records that he's been picking up. So I decided, well, before I start buying them, I better see what I have in my collection. So I came across this and thought I'd give it a spin. Really good. And this talks about Duke Ellington when he first started playing the Cotton Club back in 1929, and his run there through 1931, when he started getting bigger and was venturing out on touring and things like that. So very interesting, some good liner notes here, learned quite a bit. So King Oliver was supposed to be playing at the Cotton Club, and he declined. Thought it was beneath him to be playing there, so they scrambled and got Duke Ellington, and the rest is history. So there you go. A little bit, that was really good. Recommend this. You can probably find it fairly inexpensive. I think $3 to $7 on Discogs, so check it out. Picked this up in Port Neches, Texas. Was out there this past weekend, stopped into a little antique store, and they had a vendor that was selling records. This is one that I didn't have, Peter Gabriel, and pretty good price, $7. I believe it's a original press. I really wanted it for the cover. Not very familiar with these songs, so I'll have to give this a spin. I'm more of a 1980s Peter Gabriel fan, and this is 1980, so I'll need to check this out. Then I found this, Iggy Pop 12-inch there as well, promo, Real Wild Child. So looking forward to spinning this, haven't listened to this yet. So this was $4, pretty good price. This here, Bobby Bland introspective 2-record set of the early years. So this has some wear on the cover, looks like water damage, but the vinyl is in good condition. $6 in these parts over here. It's hard to find good blues records, so thought I'd go ahead and pick this up to check it out. My dad was with me, so he recommended it. Two thumbs up from my dad, so I'll be checking this out, probably lend it to him as well. And then I found this, Tommy Tedesco, part of the Wrecking Crew. A big Tommy Tedesco fan. I don't have any of his albums, so I was really excited to see this. And this is still sealed in the shrink. The shrink is pretty loose, so not really much to worry about there. Direct-to-disc, limited first edition. This was $14. So it's pretty much in line with what they are going for on Discogs. Haven't heard this yet, but I'll be checking it out. So some interesting songs on there. So I will check it out and report back. So this is new. This is the Rock on Tours. Picked this up on the recommendation of Richard Riley. Got this at my local record store, Hog Wild Records. And this is the indie store exclusive with the hand screen printed LP jacket and white colored vinyl. really nice. So really did enjoy this album, so I decided to pick it up on CD as well. So I've been playing this in the car and at work. So CD and vinyl. Picked this one up at Stingray Records up in New Braunfels a couple of weekends back. I haven't opened it yet, but I've had this on CD, so I was excited to get it on vinyl. Limited purple edition. I have not opened it yet, but I will. I will be opening it. It's going to be an issue with this cover because it opens here in the middle. So I might have to get some of those fancy new sleeves and put that in one of those. Soundgarden, also picked this up at Hogwild Records. I have Bad Motorfinger in multiple editions and didn't have this one. So it's like, okay, I need to get this. Of course, I always had them on CD, never on vinyl. So this is definitely a reissue, but I'm happy to have a copy of it. Add that to my collection. Picked this up as well. Prince, and this is Originals. These are songs that he wrote that were covered by other artists. The Bangles, Sinead O'Connor. Who is it? It's not... is it Vanity Six? Could be Vanity Six. Sex Shooter, The Time, Bangles. So a whole bunch of others. Really good CD. Highly recommended if you're a Prince fan. So it's nice to hear his renditions of his own songs. So, got that. Picked this up on my way back from Port Arthur, Texas. Stopped in Houston over at, what is it, Vinyl Edge? I think it's called Vinyl Edge in the Heights in Houston, Texas. Really cool record store. Picked this up. Look, I already bent it. Picked this up on CD so I could check it out. Wasn't too sure if I wanted to spring for the vinyl. It's a little bit softer than El Camino and some of their previous records, but it's still really good. Not sure if I'm going to get it on vinyl, but most likely will end up having to add it to my collection. I've been playing it quite a bit, rotation on the way back, so not bad, but like I said, not as hard rocking as their El Camino and other records. And I also picked these up at the antique store there in Port Neches. Groove, music from and inspired by the motion picture Groove. Pretty much dance music, house music. Been listening to this at work and never seen the movie, so I'm interested in seeing that. Gonna have to search that out. Stone Temple Pilots, Shangri-La. Need to give this a listen. I pretty much stopped at the one tiny... Anyhow. So, haven't really listened to this. I'll give that a spin. Couldn't leave this behind, of course. Megadeth, Rust in Peace. These were $4 each or 5 for 17. So, went for the 5 for 17. Mars Volta, this is a, I guess like a little EP, three songs on there, and another Mars Volta. I tried playing this at work in my little CD player, and it wasn't cooperating, so I'm gonna have to try it out here at home. Hopefully it works. So that's what I have been spinning, listening to, so... Thought I'd give you all an update. Thanks, VC. See you later.